I was very encouraged to hear the President announce the trade agreement with Mexico, and I'm hopeful that Canada will now re-engage, and hopefully we can have a tripartite or a three-country deal as opposed to just a bilateral deal with Mexico. My state, like many states around the country, a lot of jobs depend on that trade with Mexico and Canada. And I know many of the folks in the agriculture sector are much relieved because Mexico is a big consumer, big purchaser of our agriculture products. But I think it's an important step forward, like the President's announcements with the EU that they were moving toward a zero tariff policy. That, together with the farm bill, which I hope we're able to get on the President's desk here in the next few weeks, I think is going to be really important to reassure some folks, particularly in the agriculture sector, who are concerned about some of the retaliatory tariffs. Finally, Judge Kavanaugh will be before the Judiciary Committee starting on Tuesday, as the leader said. Chairman Grassley has, I think, done a good job shepherding this nomination through the committee, making not only Judge Kavanaugh, but also his record available to members of the Judiciary Committee who are going to question him starting perhaps next Wednesday, I guess it would be. But just to point out that the best evidence of how Judge Kavanaugh will perform on the bench is how he has done in the last 12 years as a member of the D.C. Circuit Court of Appeals. He's written 307 opinions. All of that is before every member of the committee. And in total, there are more than 400,000 individual pages of documents that have been produced. Judge Gorsuch had the most until now of 180,000 pages of documents. So this has been the most productive in terms of the documents vetting process of any nominee for the United States Supreme Court. And I look forward, along with the rest of the Senate, in performing our constitutional duties beginning next week of providing advice and consent on this important nomination.